This is the first lecture of Nuclear and Particle Physics Part 2. In the previous series of Nuclear and Particle Physics Part 1, we discussed about nucleus. There we discussed about the various properties of nucleus, the components of nucleus, and then we discussed about the various types of particles which are emitted from a nucleus. For example, the alpha particle, then the beta particle, and then the gamma radiations. And after that, we had a look at the nuclear reactions. So over here, we are going to start with Nuclear and Particle Physics Part 2. So this is a subject for 6th semester BSc non-medical students. Now, in this series, we will discuss how the nuclear radiations interact with matter, the radiations which are emitted in a nuclear reaction. So, the radiations or the particles which are emitted in a nuclear reaction are termed as nuclear radiations. So, in the first chapter, we will discuss about the interaction of nuclear radiation with matter. And after that, we will have a look at the various types of detectors which are used to detect some particles. And after that, we will discuss about the accelerators, the various types of accelerators which are used to accelerate the particles which are emitted from the nucleus. And at last, we will have a brief introduction about particle physics. So the first chapter, so in this lecture, I am just going to give you a brief introduction to the first chapter. So in the first chapter, we will see that how the nuclear radiations interact with the matter, or the nuclear radiations, how these radiations, they interact with the material medium in which these nuclear radiations are traveling. Now, what is nuclear radiation? So, nuclear radiations, these are the radiations or the particles which are emitted in a nuclear reaction, and we broadly classify the nuclear radiation into two types. So, the first type is the charged particles. So the charged particles, for example, proton, alpha particle, and the deuteron, so they come under the charged particles. So here we are just talking about the nuclear radiations which are emitted in a nuclear reaction. So the alpha particle, now alpha particle, this particle is composed of two protons and two neutrons in a bound state. And then deuteron, so deuteron is nothing but a proton and a neutron in a bound state. And at last we have a proton. So these three particles, they come under the charged particles. Then we have uncharged particles or radiation. So these are the common types of charged particles, and the common uncharged particles or radiations that come under nuclear radiations are gamma rays. As we know, when the nucleus, it comes to the lower state from a higher excited state. So if a nucleus is in an excited state, it goes to its lower state by the emission of gamma radiations. So gamma rays, they come under nuclear radiation, and these are the uncharged radiations. Then the other common example of uncharged particles are the neutrons, or we also call them as neutron radiations. Now the charged particles, they are divided into two types. So they are divided into two parts. One are the heavy charged particles and other are the light charged particles. Now these heavy and light charged particles, they are divided on the basis of their mass. So the heavy charged particles, they have a larger mass as compared to the light charged particles. So light charged particles does not mean that they are lightly charged, but in fact, they mean that their mass is very less as compared to these particles. So heavy charged particles, their mass is greater as compared to these particles. Now heavy charged particles, they are alpha particle and deuteron. So alpha particle, deuteron as well as proton, they come under heavy charged particles. And over here the other example of charged particles that I just forgot over here, that is electron, and its antiparticle is positron. So in the chapter of particle physics we will discuss what is an antiparticle. So here I'm just saying that this is the positron. So positron is an antiparticle of electron. Now the light charged particles, example of such particles are electrons and positrons. So electrons and positrons, they come under light charged particles, and alpha particle, deuteron and protons, they come under heavy charged particles. Now in this chapter we are going to see how these radiations or how these particles, they actually interact with the matter in which they are traveling. So when we make these nuclear radiations to travel in a medium, then these radiations, they interact with the material medium, and in this chapter we will see that by which process they interact. So all these particles or these radiations, they interact in a different manner. So their process of interaction is completely different from each other, and in this chapter we will discuss about all these processes by which these nuclear radiations interact in the material medium. Now this medium in which the nuclear radiations are traveling, it is also called as absorbing material. Or it is also called as stopping material. Now these nuclear radiations interact with the matter. Now how do they interact? By interaction, what do we mean? So when these nuclear radiations, they enter a material medium, so when these nuclear radiations, they enter a medium, they enter a material medium which we call as the absorbing material or the stopping material. So this is called as absorbing material or the stopping material. So these radiations, they interact with matter by transferring their energy to the material atoms or the molecules, so whichever is present inside the medium. So the nuclear radiations, they lose their energy, they transfer their energy to the material atoms or the molecules when they pass through it. So when these nuclear radiations, they enter a material medium, so there would be a large number of atoms or molecules present of the medium. Then these nuclear radiations, whether it is alpha particle, proton, neutron, gamma radiations, these electrons or positrons, so when they will enter this medium, they will lose their energy and they will transfer their energy to the material medium atoms or the molecules. Now this concept is actually used in detectors. Now what is a detector? The detector is nothing but made up of a special material. It is made up of a special medium. Now when the nuclear radiations, so detector is used to detect the particles. The detector, the nuclear detector especially, is used to detect the nuclear radiations. So nuclear detectors will be discussed in the next chapter. So the basic concept under the detectors is that when the nuclear radiations which has to be detected, these radiations when enter the medium of the detector, they interact with the atoms of the medium. Now while they will interact, they will lose their energy. So by interaction, what do we mean? The particles which are entering the medium, they will lose their energy, they will transfer their energy to the atoms or the molecules of the medium. So this can be detected with the help of the electronic system which is attached to the detector. So for example, firstly, the heavy charged particles, How do the heavy charged particles interact? So there are two processes, mainly two processes by which the heavy charged particles interact with the matter. So first is the ionization process and second is excitation process. So by ionization means when the alpha particle or deuteron or proton enters a medium, so they will have certain amount of energy, they will be moving with certain velocity, so they will have certain amount of energy in itself. So when these nuclear radiations, they enter the medium, so what can they do? They can either cause ionization or they can cause excitation of the atoms of the medium. So by ionization we mean that these particles, they will knock out the electrons, the orbital electrons which are revolving around the atoms, which are revolving in the atoms of the material medium. So when these nuclear radiations enter, they will knock out the outer electrons, the orbital electrons of the atom. So these atoms are of the material medium. So the orbital electrons are knocked out by the incoming nuclear radiation. So that process is the ionization process. And the other process that can happen in the case of heavy charged particles is the excitation. So if the nuclear radiation particle, the heavy charged particle is entering the material medium, so it will transfer its energy to the atom. Now, instead of ionization of the atom goes to its excited state by absorbing the energy. So when it will de-excite, it will emit photons. Now in the case of ionization, we have seen that electrons are knocked out, the orbital electrons are knocked out. So when heavy charged particles enter, so either electrons are knocked out or the photons are emitted due to the de-excitation of the atoms of the medium. So the nuclear radiation, the heavy charged particles can cause excitation of the atom of the medium, and after the excitation, if the atom of the medium will de-excite, it will emit photons. So in the case of ionization, electrons are emitted. In the case of excitation, after the excitation process, the photons are emitted. So the electronic system which is attached to a detector. So the electronic system which is attached to a detector, it is capable of detecting these electrons and the photons which are emitted. So the detector can easily, the electronic system which is attached to the detector can easily detect these particles. So the detector is able to detect that some radiations have entered the medium. So if this radiation, if these particles do not interact with the atoms of the medium, that is, they will not cause any process, they will not transfer their energy to the atoms of the medium, so there will be no output pulse from the detector. So in the electronic system which is attached to the detector, there will be no output pulse, so there will be no detection. So such particles will be undetected, they will go undetected. So if the nuclear radiation interacts, that is, it loses its energy inside the medium, only then it can be detected. So the heavy charged particles, we have seen that they interact by two processes. So these are the two main processes. First is the ionization process and another is the excitation process. Now in the case of light charged particles, that is the electrons or the positrons. So how the light charged particles interact with the medium? So if instead of heavy charged particles, if you will have the light charged particles which are going inside a medium, so how do they interact with the medium? So the two processes which were present over here, so these two processes of interaction will remain same in the case of light charged particles. That is, light charged particles, they will cause ionization inside the medium as well as they can cause excitation. So they will lose their energy. The light charged particles can lose their energy either by ionization or by excitation. But in the case of light charged particles, there is another energy loss which contributes. So there is another process which contributes to the energy loss of the light charged particles, and that is the radiation loss. So this we will discuss in more detail when we will be studying about the interaction of light charged particles in the medium. So there are mainly three processes by which the light charged particles lose energy inside the medium in which they are traveling. So first is the ionization process, second is excitation process, and the last one is the radiation loss. Now the uncharged particles, how these uncharged particles interact with the medium. Now the neutrons, they interact via nuclear forces. Now these ionizations and excitations, these are caused due to Coulombic interactions. As you can see that the alpha particle is a charged particle, deuteron is a charged particle, proton is a charged particle, electron is a charged particle, positron is a charged particle. So these particles, they interact via Coulombic interaction with the electrons, with the orbital electrons of the material medium. But in the case of neutrons and gamma rays, so there is no Coulombic interaction in this case. So these neutrons or the neutron radiations, they interact via nuclear force. And the gamma radiations, they interact via three main processes. First is the photoelectric effect. Second is the Compton scattering. So these you have already studied in quantum mechanics. And last one is the pair production. So if the energy of gamma ray is very large, that is it is in mega electron volts, then it can cause pair production inside the medium. So the gamma photon can lose its energy either in the form of photoelectric effect or Compton scattering or pair production. So there are three main processes by which the gamma radiations can interact with the atoms of the material medium. Now the interaction of neutrons with the matter is not a part of the syllabus, but we will discuss about interaction of gamma radiations with the material medium. So all these interactions, that is the interaction of heavy charged particles with matter, interaction of light charged particles with matter, and interaction of gamma photons with matter, these all processes will be discussed in more detail in the incoming lectures. So the main idea over here is that the nuclear radiation loses its energy. So whichever type of nuclear radiation you are talking about, any nuclear radiation, when it will travel inside a medium, it will lose its energy, and it loses its energy according to the type of radiation. So it loses its energy, it transfers its energy to the atoms of the material medium, and this loss of energy can be detected by the various electronic systems which are attached to the detector. So this is the basic idea after the detectors, the nuclear detectors, which we will discuss in the next chapter. So in the next lecture, we will discuss about the interaction of heavy charged particles with matter.